So we've completed our steel wire armoured sub-main circuit, where we have a 60 amp switch fuse feeding a consumer's unit. We're trying to simulate perhaps a block of flats where there's several 60 amp switch fuses in the basement, and steel wire armoured cables go up to each floor in turn to feed the consumer unit within each of the flats. We're going to carry out our continuity of CPC and polarity test, and follow it by our insulation resistance test in this presentation. So I'm getting set up to do my continuity of CPC and polarity test. I've linked together at the tails the line conductor and the earthing conductor. So my circuit passes therefore through my 60 amp switch fuse and comes all the way to the furthest point of the radial, which is the top connection here of the RCCB for the line and into the earth bar. We're going to also need to confirm that I'm actually using the correct conductor for my CPC. I've used black at this end, and hopefully I've used black at that end. We've had issues before where students have got it in reverse. At one end, they've used black as a circuit protective conductor, and at the other end, they've misplaced it and used the grey as a circuit protective conductor. We didn't pick this up when we tested between it connected to the earth bar and line during the continuity test, because we have a parallel path between the two points. The steel wire armoured itself also passes a circuit protective conductor from the isolator to the consumer's unit. In order to prove polarity, I'm asking my learners to disconnect, in this case, the black conductor, removing the parallel path set up by the armouring, in order that we can also prove polarity. So we're going to disconnect the black conductor. From the disconnected black conductor, which is our CPC connector, our tester between there and line, we've got our tails linked together, and we're going to take a reading. We then operate the switch and remove the fuse in order to prove polarity. We're then going to replace the black CPC conductor identifier with green and yellow sleeving and repeat the test again with the parallel path of the armouring in. We should see the second test as a slightly lower reading than the first. So I've disconnected the circuit protective conductor within the steel wire armoured, the core, which is black identified with green and yellow sleeving. I'm going to test between the disconnected conductor and the line conductor, which is connected in the top of the RCCB. By removing the CPC from the earth bar, we remove the parallel path created by the steel wire armoured, which can give us a confusing reading for polarity. In other words, if I'd used the black conductor this end as my CPC, but I'd used the grey conductor at this end, we will have created a path between here and the earth bar if this was connected that would give us a reading for R1 plus R2. So in order to prove polarity, I've disconnected the conductor used for the CPC, and we'll test between the disconnected conductor and line in order to achieve my R1 plus R2 reading. So let's connect onto the circuit protective conductor and the top of the RCCB. I get a reading of 0.05 ohms. In order to prove polarity, I need to operate the switch. We see the circuit now go off and then hopefully comes back on through full scale deflection. However, as this is a double pole switch operating both live conductors, I need to pull the fuse and see the circuit go open again and close in order to prove polarity. Polarity proving that we switch and fuse in the line conductor. I'm now going to reconnect my black conductor identified with green and yellow sleeving as my CPC into my earth bar and repeat the test again with the parallel path in. Possibly won't see a smaller reading because the job is very tiny in length, but we should therefore see maybe a change in the reading as we reconnect it in and we have both the copper conductor and the steel armouring as our circuit protective conductors. Let's do that in the next part of the presentation. So I've reconnected my black conductor identified with green and yellow sleeving within the steel wire armoured construction, which has now meant that it's gone back into the earth bar, which is also picked up through the fly lead, the armouring between both locations as a parallel earth path. We should potentially see a lower reading now for R1 plus R2, our continuity of CPC reading, because we've got the copper conductor and the steel wire armoured now as part of the earth path. Let's connect on and see what we get. And I've got a reading of 0.03. Again, I can prove polarity by operating the switch. And we see the circuit goes off. But as stated previously, we know it's a double pole switch, so it's line and neutral being operated. We pull the fuse, circuit goes off, we reconnect the circuit. So by doing the test in two ways, with the disconnected conductor for a first stage, R1 plus R2 continuity of CPC and polarity part of the test, we're helping to prove polarity, that we haven't got conductors mixed up. One end uses black, one end uses grey. We've proved that. We've then reconnected it into the earth bar to have the parallel path created by the armouring, and we saw we had a lower reading for our continuity of CPC. We will record the highest reading of 0.06. We suffice polarity by operating the switch, pulling the fuse, and confirming the conductor, in this case black, is the circuit protective conductor. We're now ready to move on to insulation resistance test. So this time we're going to carry out the insulation resistance test from the tails themselves. My students are aware that the earthing conductor needs connecting to the supply authority's earth and isn't for this test, but we're going to go through the sequence of tests anyhow. We're going to connect together in any order we like, so we'll do live conductors first, testing at 500 volts DC. We got a reading greater than the machine can read, so we went off the scale at 999 megaohms. Move it around, we're going to do line conductor to earthing conductor. And we've got the same reading, greater than the machine can read. And finally, between the earthing conductor and neutral. Once again, greater than the machine can read. We've got the switch here in the on position. We've got the fuse in circuit, and the RCCB is in the off position because the electronic component's within it. And the insulation resistance test has been completed. However, the eagle-eyed people amongst you will be stating in the comments to me, why are we earthing the tray when it doesn't need earthing? It's neither an exposed nor extraneous conductive part. Me and my students have had that conversation and they're fully aware of that. The tray itself does not induce a potential from outside, therefore doesn't require connecting to earth. However, the awarding body we're currently working for requires it to be earthed in their marking criteria, hence that they have earthed it. They are fully aware that they didn't need to.